Today is April 27, 2024, Saturday within the fourth week of Easter Year B. Today's Gospel is from the beautiful and the wonderful account of the Gospel of John, chapter 14, verses 7 to 14. Today's Gospel is the continuation of yesterday's account, and it describes the disciples as being troubled, worried, and anxious. And because of this, one among the disciples expressed his longing, expressed his inner desire for Jesus to finally show them the Father, and it would be enough for them. And Philip said, and I quote, "Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied." But Jesus said to him in reply, "Philip, have I been with you all the time, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father." My dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel is telling us today that Jesus is the human face of God. To see God is to experience what God is like. Jesus revealed the Father. Whoever sees me has seen the Father. And you know, what is interesting to know, sometimes in our life, like the disciples, many of us question the existence of God when we are in trouble. And we ask sometimes this question, where is God? Why is this happening to me? We don't feel His presence when challenges arises. You know, many of us, including myself, we believe in God. We worship Him. We serve Him, but sometimes we question His existence. We question His love when our faith is tested by the storms of life. And like Philip, he also asks, "Show us the Father and we will be satisfied." Today, let us be reminded again, like Philip, amidst of our troubled hearts, amidst of the problems, sickness, financial struggles, psychological issues, and other crises we face in our life, let us proclaim and boldly acclaim, "Lord, You are my satisfaction. You, O Lord, have done marvelous things in my life." But you know what, my dear friends, my dear brothers and sisters, our first reading for today is also telling us of this. If we proclaim and we acclaim Jesus as the satisfaction of our life, if we proclaim the marvelous things God has done in our life, two things will be the consequences according to our first reading. Number one, the Gentiles and the non-believer will be glad and praise the Lord. Let us be like Paul and Barnabas. Speak courageously, you know. Do not be afraid of critics and haters. Do not be afraid to proclaim your faith. Do not be afraid to share your experience of God. Share your faith. Share the Lord. And let our community gather together to hear the word of the Lord. Let our community, our family gather together and share our experience of the goodness of God. And second things most likely will happen is this. There will be, or you will be, or we will be, we will experience persecution and harassment. Meaning to say, we will be hated by others. We will be rejected by others. We will be persecuted, you know, and harassed. And some will not welcome the truth that we bring. And how to deal with this experience? We are reminded in our first reading for today, if you are persecuted, rejected, and hated, shake off the dusts on your feet. This is a gesture of concern. This is a gesture of warning, telling the unbelievers and telling those who refuse to believe in the truth that we bring, to shake off the dust on our feet. Meaning to say, we're telling them, we are not responsible of your condemnation because of the rejection of the truth that we are offering to you. That's why, my dear friends, if people refuse to believe the word of God, move and shake off the dust on your feet. If others will not accept the truth that you bring, the truth about your faith, live with joy and with smiles on your face and shake off the dust on your feet. Finally, we need to rejoice because the Lord promised us of this. And if you have a Bible, open John chapter 14, verse 14. And the Lord said, if in my name you ask for anything, I will do it. Rejoice because that's the promise of God. If you ask anything in Jesus' name, He will grant it. Today, whatever amidst of our worries, amidst of our struggles, amidst of our difficulties, present to the Lord your concerns. Surrender to God your desires. And remember the ABC of life. A, asks. B, believe. And C, claim what you ask for. Because God said, if in my name you ask for anything, I will do it. If you love and like this reflection, kindly share it with your friends, share it with your family. Make the word of God viral so that many will be blessed. And today, we say, Lord, you are our satisfaction. Amen.